Hello, hello, hello. Solution to problem 131. If the mass of the branch is m, and you have to move it over a vertical distance h, which is 20 meters, then the energy that it takes to move it over that distance is mgh. That's non-negotiable. That's always there. However, if one part of the branch is on the ground and is dragged slowly up to the 20 meters, then there is friction with the ground. And that means you have to overcome that friction. If we call the frictional force Fr, and you move all the way a distance d, which could be a mile, then the energy that you have to produce in addition to mgh is the frictional force times d. Now, what is the frictional force? Go back to my A to 1 lectures. It is the friction coefficient, we call that mu, times the normal force. The normal force is the force from the road up on the branch, where it touches the ground. That normal force is way higher when you have that heavy part of the branch on the ground. Therefore, you have to do way more work to overcome that friction than if the very low mass part of the branch were on the ground. So even though it may be very uncomfortable to drag the heavy part in your hands, to hold the heavy part in your hand and to drag the very light part of the branch on the road, it may be very uncomfortable, energetically, from a work point of view, the way we define work in physics, the best way is indeed to have the heavy part in your hand to reduce friction. Now, some of you will say, when I have a heavy object in my hand and just stand still, and I hold that heavy object in my hand for half an hour, I get very, very, very tired. I agree with you. But from a physics point of view, you have done no work, because you could put that heavy, heavy part on the table. You would agree with me that the table does no work. Now, the table cannot get tired, but that's a separate issue. So the answer to 131 is, from a energy point of view, from a work point of view, by far the best would be to hold the heavy part of the branch in your hand and to let the very light part hit the ground. That minimizes the friction, and therefore it minimizes your energy. Many of you have this right. I would say 40% of you have it right. Many of you argue about centers of mass, and they use all kinds of heavy language. It has nothing to do with that. All what matters is, what is the friction? That is what you have to overcome. And the friction is proportional to the normal force. End of story. The larger the normal force, the larger the friction. That's all. It's a very simple problem. But what counts is that you accept the fact that physics is not about equations. It's about concepts. We'll be friends. That's always a given.